Welcome to Tungal Online Classes. Today we are going to discuss about the concept of simple microscope. Simple microscope. What is a simple microscope and for which purpose we are considering the simple microscope means? In the last class we defined three definitions. First one is what? Angle of vision or visual angle. Second one is what? Far point and nearer point. First, before going to the define what is a simple microscope, here I want to explain what is the need of consideration of the simple microscope. So, what is the need of consideration of the simple microscope means, by using the simple microscope, here we are increasing the angle of vision. What is the basic need of the simple microscope means, by using the simple microscope, We are increasing the angle of vision. We are increasing what? Angle of vision by using the simple microscope. Actually, this is a main reason for a consideration of the simple microscope. What is the basic reason for the consideration of what? Simple microscope means by using the simple microscope, in generally we are increasing the angle of vision. What is the need to increasing the angle of vision? What is the need to increasing the angle of vision? Before going to that, first we will define what is the angle of vision. If you consider any one of the object, that object will be placed in front of the eye, so that this object will be making certain angle with respect to the eye. Such a type of angle we are calling as a what? Angle of vision or visible angle. So that how can we define the angle of vision or visible angle? So it is defined as theta naught will be calling as a what? Visual angle. So that the angle made by the object, with respect to the eye or with the eye, the angle made by the object with the eye is called as visual angle. See, already I told, by using the simple microscope, we are increasing the angle of vision. And also you defined the angle of vision is nothing but the angle made by the object with respect to the eye will be calling as what? Angle of vision. So, what is the need to increasing the angle of vision? What happens if you increasing the angle of vision value? So, for that, we will consider two examples. First, with our naked eye, we are seeing a very distant object. With the naked eye, we are seeing a what? Very distant object. When you are seeing the very distant object, that will be appears as a very small, is it right? Whenever you are looking towards the distant objects, they will be appears smaller in size. Why they will be appeared in smaller in size means, already I told in the last class. The size of the image which is formed on the retina is directly proportional to the angle made by the object with respect to the eye. Once again, the size of the image which is formed on the retina is directly proportional to the angle made by the object with respect to the eye. That angle only we are calling as a what? Angle of vision. That means what? When you are seeing the distant objects, the angle of vision will be very small. As a result, the size of the image which is formed on the retina will be very small. So that the first point is what? For distant objects. First, which type of object I consider here? For the distant object, angle of vision value will be small. If angle of vision will be small, then what we will write? Size of the image which is formed on the retina is also small. Why the size of the image will be small if the angle of vision will be small means, already we told, the size of the image The size of the image is directly proportional to angle of vision. Size of the image is directly proportional to what? Angle of vision. If you are increasing the theta value, the size of the image which is formed on the retina is also what? Increases. Now, whatever the distant object I was seen earlier, the same object will be brought closer to the eye. In the second case, what I did, initially I am seeing one particular object which was placed at very long distance. In that case, the size of the image that was appears to us, felt by us, will be very small. Why? That will be making a smaller angle with respect to the eye whenever it is at the larger distances. If the same object will be brought closer to the eye, then what happens? The angle made by the object, with respect to the eye will be increases. Whenever the theta value will be increases, what you find here, the size of the image is also increases. That means by bringing the distant object, nearer to the eye, you increase the theta value. As a result, you felt that I am seeing the image will be in bigger in size. But what happens? Whenever you are seeing the distant objects, the eye will be, least strained, So whenever you are seeing the very distant objects, how much time you are seeing the same object, the eye should not be getting strained whenever you are looking towards the distant object. But if the same object will be brought closer to the eye, theta value increases, size of the image is also increases, but the eye will be getting strained. You are not able to see the object for the longer time, even though that it was placed in front of you, because your eye will be getting strained. So that whenever the object will be closer, what happens? Angle of vision, theta naught value increases. Whenever the angle of vision, theta naught will be increases, size of the image is also increases. That means you will see the bigger in size, but the eye will be, most strained. The eye will be what? Most strained whenever the object will be placed nearer to the eye. Then which is easier to see the object? The first one is easier. Why? Even though that will be appears in smaller in size, our eye should not be getting strained. But in the second case, whenever the object will be brought closer to the eye, even though you are seeing the object by bigger in size, but your eye will be getting what? Strained. So we are not able to see the objects for the longer time. For which purpose? Here two things are needed. First one is what? I don't compromise. I want to see the bigger sizes images. So that I want the bigger size in images, and my eye will be in safer side. That means the eye should not be getting the strained. So that for getting the images bigger in size, and the eye should be, least strained, we need optical instruments. Why we need the optical instruments means what? For getting the images bigger in size and to reducing the strain that is felt by the eye, we need the optical instruments. For that purpose, we consider the simple microscope as well as the compound microscope. This is the reason behind the consideration of the simple microscope as well as the compound microscope. so that by using the simple microscope, what we are doing here, we are increasing the angle of vision, we are increasing the angle of vision. As a result, you see the images in bigger in size and your eye will be what? Least strained. So this is the basic information about simple microscope. Simple microscope. Now, next, see here. Up to now what we discuss, what is the need of the simple microscope? What is the need of the simple microscope? Now we are going to define what is a simple microscope. What is the simple microscope? See here. What is a simple microscope means? A simple microscope is a consisting of, simple microscope is a consisting of a convex lens which is having the smaller focal length. Simple microscope is a consisting of what? It is a consisting of a single convex lens. It is a consisting of a single convex lens and whose focal length value will be smaller and which is fitted in a given metallic frame and that is providing a handle to hold it. So that is the construction of the simple microscope. So how can we define a simple microscope? Simple microscope is consisting of a single convex lens, comma, having smaller in focal length, and it is fitted in a metallic frame and providing a handle to hold it. So this is the definition of the simple microscope. What is the definition of the simple microscope? It is consisting of a single convex lens and whose focal length value will be smaller and it is fitted in a given metallic frame and a small handle will be provided for holding it. So that is calling as a what? Simple microscope. This is simple microscope also calling as a reading lens. It is also calling as a reading lens. So the simple microscope will be also calling as a reading lens or magnifier. Why we are calling it is as a magnifier means, just now only we told what is a basic need to consider the simple microscope means what? It is increasing the angle of the vision. As a result, the size of the image is also to be increases, so that it will be magnifying the size of the images. That's why the simple microscope will be also calling as a what? Magnifier. Now, coming to the derivation part. See here, in this diagram, this is the eye. O dash will be indicating the object. So first I consider the object which was seen by our eye only. So here, whenever you are seeing the object with your eye, that object will be making certain angle with respect to the eye. That angle already we told, angle of vision or visual angle. So when the visual angle will be maximum for the naked eye means, important, whenever the visual angle value will be maximum for the naked eye means, whenever the object will be placed at nearer point, the angle of vision value will be maximum. Why that object will be placed at that point only? Already I told. When we see the objects by very clearly means, whenever the object is placed in between, nearer point to the far point, we able to see the object. But whenever the object is at a far point, the angle of vision will be very small. Whenever the object will be bringing closer to the eye, the angle of vision will be increases. But whenever the object will be at a least distance of 25 centimeter, then only you are seeing the object by very clearly. If you If you bring the object very closer to the eye below the 25 centimeter, you are not able to detecting the object. So that at a given least distance only you find the object, you will see the object. That least distance only we are indicating with the capital D. So here capital D value is equal to what? 25 centimeter for the normal eye, for the 25 centimeter for the normal eye. So that at that point only you are seeing the object bigger in size. Bigger in size means what? Angle of vision is also maximum. So that whenever the object was placed at the nearer point, the angle of vision which was made with the naked eye will be maximum. So that the first point is when the object is placed at, when the object is placed at nearer point theta naught will be maximum. Theta naught will be maximum. That theta naught is indicating what? Angle of vision which was made by the object with the naked eye. So here one right angle triangle will be there. So for the smaller angles, tan theta is equal to theta. So I will write tan theta naught is equal to h by d. Tan theta naught is equal to what? H by d. If a theta will be very small, from this I will write theta naught is equal to h by d, equation number 1. Theta naught is equal to what? H by d, equation number 1. What is the theta naught? Angle of vision for the naked eye. Whenever the object will be placed at the nearer point. I got the equation number 1. Now see here. You got the equation theta naught is equal to h by d. What is this? Theta naught is the angle made by the object with respect to the eye. So there the theta naught value will be very small. Since we are seeing the object with respect to our naked eye. Now I want to increasing the angle of the vision. For that purpose, what we are considering here, simple microscope will be considered. Simple microscope is nothing but a single convex lens, I told. So that to increasing the angle of vision, we are placing a convex lens. In front of our eye. So that here, in between the eye and the object, we are placing a convex lens. So where we are placing the convex lens? See here, the object is placed in front of the convex lens, and the position of the object is equal to what? The position of the object will be placed in between focus to the optic center. What is the position of the object with respect to the simple microscope? With respect to the convex lens means the object will be placed in between the principal focus to the optic center. In the case of the ray diagrams of the convex lenses, we made a table, object position and image position. So whenever the object will be placed within the focal plane, or in between the principal focus to the optic center, the corresponding image will be the virtual image and erected and magnified image. So when the image will be magnified, whenever the object will be placed in between the principal focus to the optic center of a given convex lens, the corresponding image will be what? Virtual, erected and magnified. So that this convex lens will be magnifying the images, So that here this object O dash again making some angle theta with respect to the optical instrument, or eye lens. So that here theta will be calling as angle of vision for simple microscope or the angle made by the object with respect to the convex lens. From this diagram I will write tan theta is equal to, how can we write? H by the distance of the object will be taken as u. The distance of the object from the object lens is equal to what? U. So that tan theta is equal to h by u. tan theta is equal to what? H by u. If theta will be smaller, again tan theta value is equal to what? Theta. Therefore, tan theta value becomes to what? Theta. Theta is equal to what? H by u. H by u. So you got the theta naught, angle of vision with respect to the naked eye, theta, angle of vision with respect to the given simple microscope. Now, we are defining magnifying power of a simple microscope. Magnifying power of a simple microscope is equal to theta by theta naught. Magnifying power of a simple microscope will be defined as what? It is the ratio of theta by theta naught. What is the theta? Angle of vision with respect to the instrument. What is the theta? Angle of vision with respect to the instrument. Which type of instrument you consider here? Simple microscope. So that here theta will be indicating what? Angle of vision with respect to the given instrument. And theta naught is indicating what? Angle of vision with respect to the naked eye. So that the magnifying power will be defined as, it is the ratio of angle of vision made by the object with respect to the given instrument to the angle of vision made by the same object with respect to the naked eye. Once again, how can we define the magnifying power? It is defined as the ratio of angle of vision made by the object with respect to the given instrument to the angle of vision made by the same object with respect to the naked eye. From the equations 1, 2, 3, we will write m is equal to. What is the theta from the equation number 2? H by u. And from the equation number 1, for theta naught value is equal to what? H by d. HH will be getting cancelled. Therefore, magnifying power is equal to what? D by u. What is the u? Object distance. See here. For the given lens, we have a lens formula. What is the lens formula? 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. 1 by f is equal to what? 1 by v minus 1 by u. What are v, u? V, u will be the object distance as well as the image distance. If you follow the sign conventions, what are the sign conventions? All the distances which are measured in the direction of the incident light rays, they will be taken as a positive. Incidental light rays are traveling in this direction. And all the distances are measured from the center of the given convex lens. See here, object distance will be measured in this direction, which is opposite to the direction of the incident light ray. So that the object distance u value becomes to what? Minus u. And the image will be formed on the same side. So that image distance is also measured in this direction. So that image distance is also taken as minus v. So according to the same conventions, in the place of u, I am writing minus u. In the place of v, I am writing minus v. So that the equation becomes to what? Equation number 4. See here. From this equation, 1 by f is equal to 1 by v minus 1 by u. Here I am substituting the values of u, v along with the sign conventions. Therefore, 1 by f is equal to 1 by, in the place of v, I will write a minus v, minus 1 by u. In the place of u, we have to write again minus u, minus 1 by u. So it becomes to what? 1 by f is equal to minus 1 by v plus 1 by u. That implies 1 by u is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by f. So what is the value of 1 by u? 1 by u is equal to what? 1 by v plus 1 by f. 1 by v plus 1 by f. Once again, see the equation 4 comma 5. So this is our required equation. Magnifying power is equal to what? D by u. So from 4 comma 5, magnifying power of the given simple microscope M is equal to D into 1 by u. D into 1 by u value is equal to what? 1 by v plus 1 by f. Therefore, m is equal to, you got d by v plus d by f. So this is the general equation for magnifying power of a simple microscope. General equation for what? Magnifying power of a simple microscope. Here are two cases are there. Case one. If the final image will be formed at infinite distance, when the final image will be formed at infinite distance, when the object will be placed at the principal focus, So, if object is placed at principal focus, image will be formed at infinite distance. If image will be formed at infinite distance, image distance value is equal to infinity. What is the first case? Whenever the object will be placed at the principal focus, image will be formed at infinity. So what condition we consider here? If the final image will be formed at the infinity, for that image distance value is equal to infinity. Therefore, magnifying power for the final image will be formed at infinite distance will be indicated by m infinity. So from this equation, d by infinity plus d by f, 1 by infinity value is equal to 0. Therefore, the magnifying power of the simple microscope in the case 1 is equal to m infinity is equal to d by f. So this is the case 1, whenever the final image will be formed at infinite distance. Case 2. If the final image will be formed at nearer point, or it is also calling as least distance of distinct vision. So whenever the final image will be formed at the nearer point, the image distance V is equal to capital D. Image distance V value is equal to what? Capital D. Whenever the final image will be formed at the infinite distance, the image distance value is equal to what? Infinity. Whenever the final image will be formed at the nearer point, image distance value is equal to what? Capital D. From the equation 6, we will write M is equal to D by V plus D by F. So in the place of V, what we will write? A capital D. Therefore, D by D plus D by F, DD will be getting cancelled. So whenever the final image will be formed at least distance of distinct vision, the magnifying power of the simple microscope will be MD is equal to 1 plus D by F. Whenever the final image will be formed at infinite distance, so here, the eye will be least strained, but the magnifying power will be minimum. The magnifying power value will be minimum. So whenever the final image will be formed at infinite distance, the magnifying power of the simple microscope will be what? Minimum. But whenever the final image will be formed at least distance of distinct vision, the magnifying power will be maximum. So these are the expressions for the magnifying power of a simple microscope. See the next concept, a compound microscope. Just now only we completed the simple microscope concept. What is a simple microscope? The simple microscope is consisting of only single convex lens, and it will be acting as a reading lens or a magnifier. And there is a limitations are there for the simple microscope. What is the magnification produced by the simple microscope will be the smaller in magnitude only. Whenever you want the higher magnifying powers, simple microscope is not useful. That's why we use the another microscope that will be calling as a what? Compound microscope. In the case of the simple microscope, you just used only one convex lens, but in the case of the compound microscope, here we are using two types of convex lenses. One of the lens will be having smaller aperture. This lens will be having about smaller aperture, and this lens will be having about larger aperture. And the lens which is facing towards the object, such a type of lens we are calling as a what? Objective lens. And the lens which is closer to the eye, that lens will be calling as eye lens or eyepiece. In general, eyepiece means what? The lens which is closer to the eye, that will be calling as a what? Eye lens or eyepiece. So here f0 will be indicating the focal length of the objective lens, and fe will be indicating the focal length of the eye lens. In the case of the compound microscope, the final image will be formed in two different steps. In the case one, whatever the actual object we are considering, that object will be placed in front of the objective lens, and this lens will be forming its image behind the objective lens. And whatever the image formed by the objective lens, that will be acting as a object for the eye lens. The image which is produced by the objective lens will be acting as an object for the eyepiece. As a result, its corresponding image will be produced finally. So that a final image only we are taking as a what? The final image which is produced by the compound microscope. So this is a general description about the compound microscope. Now, coming to the ray diagram of the compound microscope. See here. In this given ray diagram, first we will discuss about objective lens. For the objective lens, the object will be placed in between f0 to 2f0. So first we will discuss for which lens? For objective lens. For the objective lens, the object will be placed in between what? f0 to 2f0. Already we discussed object and image positions of the convex lens. Whenever the object will be placed between f0 and 2f0, its image will be formed on the another side of the lens, and the image will be formed between 2f0 to infinity, when the object will be placed between f0 to 2f0, the image will be produced in between where and where? 2f0 to infinity. And what is the nature of the image whenever the object will be placed in between f0 to 2f0? Means the image will be real, inverted, and enlarged. Whenever the object was placed in between f0 to 2f0. Already this table we discussed and you know also. So that whenever the object was placed in front of the objective lens, its corresponding image will be taken as I0. So I0 will be indicating what? So here I0 will be the image of objective lens. So what is the I0 in the given diagram? I0 will be indicating the image for the objective lens. So this image will be formed at a distance of small v0, from the objective lens. Because of we consider the objective lens, so that its image distance as well as objective distances will be indicating with u0, v0. u0 is indicating the objective distance for the objective lens. V0 is indicating what? Image distance for the objective lens. So this is the what? I0 will be indicating what? Image that is produced by the objective lens. Later, what we told. Whatever the image I0 this image I naught will be produced, this image I naught will be produced within the focal plane of the eyepiece. Where the I naught will be produced here, the image which is produced by the objective lens will be existed within the focal plane of, will be existed within the focal plane of the eyepiece. This point is very important, so that the I naught will be formed, the I naught will be formed within the focal plane of, within the focal plane of eyepiece, within the focal plane of eyepiece. So whenever it is formed within the focal plane of the eyepiece, if it is acting as a object for the eyepiece, its corresponding image will be virtual. Whenever the object will be placed within the focal plane of the given lens, focal plane of the given lens means what? Suppose we are assuming that it is a what, eye lens or eyepiece. See here, FE will be indicating what? Principal focus of the eyepiece. FE will be indicating what? Principal focus of the eyepiece, and the object will be placed where? Between the principal focus to the optic center, so that whenever the object will be placed between the principal focus to the optic center, the nature of the image is what? The nature of the image will be in virtual, erected and enlarged. Virtual and erected and enlarged. So that whenever the object I naught will be present within the focal plane of the eyepiece, the final image will be virtual erected and enlarged. So erected means what? Whenever the object will be placed in front of the given eyepiece, the image is also produced along the same side. Here the object will be placed below the principal axis, so that the final image is also produced below the principal axis. Then only we are saying that the object will be said to be what? Erected image. So that whenever the I naught will be formed within the focal plane of the eyepiece, the corresponding image which is produced by the eyepiece will be, its nature will be virtual, erected and enlarged. Now we are going to derive the derivation for the magnifying power of the compound microscope. Simple thing here. So what we consider here, basically two lenses you consider, one is the objective lens and the other one is a what, eye lens. So O will be indicating what, object for the objective lens, its image will be represented by I naught, and this I naught will be formed where? Within the focal plane of the eyepiece, within the focal plane of the eyepiece. Whenever I naught will be acting as the object for the eye lens or eyepiece, it will be forming its image within the focal plane of the eyepiece. As a result, its nature will be given by virtual, erected and enlarged. Now we are going to derive the expression for the magnifying power of the compound microscope. Already in the case of the simple microscope, we define the magnifying power. How can we define the magnifying power? Magnifying power small m is equal to the angle made by the object with respect to the eye, or the visual angle for the object with respect to the given instrument, by visual angle made by the object with respect to the naked eye. So how can we define the magnifying power? It is defined as the ratio of visual angle with the eyepiece by visual angle with the naked eye. How can we define the magnifying power? It is defined as the ratio of visual angle made by the object with respect to the eye lens or eyepiece to the visual angle made by the object with respect to the naked eye. See here. Already before going to starting the simple microscope as well as the compound microscope, we taken here, if we consider the object whose height is equal to h, which is making an angle theta naught with respect to the naked eye, then we defined the angle, visual angle theta naught is equal to V defined. Theta naught is equal to H by D. What is the theta naught? Visual angle for the object with respect to the naked eye. With respect to the naked eye. And here, coming to this diagram, we are discussing about the eyepiece. So here, I naught will be acting as the object for the eyepiece. I naught will be acting as how? Object for the eyepiece. And which is making an angle theta, with respect to the eyepiece. So from the figure, theta is indicating what? Angle made by the object. So that object will be calling as what? I naught with the eyepiece. That angle only we are calling as what? A visual angle. So here, if you are assuming I naught will be the object for the eye lens, it will be making an angle theta with respect to the eyepiece. From this diagram, see here, if it is the theta, opposite side length is equal to H dash, and this distance, the distance from the object to the optic center is equal to what? So object distance, that is represented by U suffix E. U suffix E is indicating what? Object distance for the eyepiece. So from that diagram we will write tan theta is equal to H dash by UE. If theta will be small, tan theta will be taken as a what? Theta. Therefore, theta is equal to H dash by UE. So, we know that the visual angle for the given object with respect to the naked eye, that value will be remains constant. And what is the theta we assumed here? Theta will be the angle made by the object with respect to the eyepiece. From this given diagram, tan theta is equal to H dash by UE. So that from that, theta is equal to what I wrote? H dash by UE. From 1, 2, we will write M is equal to what? Theta by theta naught, M is equal to what? So you substitute the theta value from here. H dash by UE by H by D. Therefore, magnifying power is equal to H dash by H, into D by UE. This is the general expression for the magnifying power of the compound microscope. Next, see here. What you got the equation? M is equal to H dash by H into D by UE. See here. What is the H dash by H? H dash is indicating what? The size of the image. Which is produced by the objective lens. H dash is indicating what? And H is indicating what? The size of the object for the objective lens. So that from the objective lens, we will write. See here. Look at the diagram. If this angle value is equal to some theta double dash, we will assume. This angle is also will be remain same, theta double dash. So that these two triangles, will be the similar triangles. From this we will write, first triangle I will write, tan theta double dash value is equal to what? H by U naught. So that from the first triangle I will write, tan theta double dash is equal to H by U naught. And from the second triangle, again tan theta double dash is equal to H dash by V naught. Opposite side by adjacent side. V naught will be indicating the image distance for the objective lens. Once again, see here, I am considering the objective lens only. For the objective lens, these two triangles are the similar triangles. I am assuming that to understand more easily, so that the angle value will be taken as a theta double dash. Tan theta double dash is equal to H by U naught. Again from here, tan theta double dash is equal to H dash by V naught. So that tan theta double dash is equal to H dash by V naught. Equating these two each other. See here, these two values will be remain same, left side values. So that I will write H by h by u naught is equal to h dash by v naught. H dash by v naught. See here, you follow the sign conventions here. Here h will be positive. H will be positive. Why? It is measured above the principal axis. And u naught value will be taken as the negative. Why? Objective distance will be measured opposite to the direction of the incident light. So this value will be negative. Next, h dash will be what? H dash will be measured below the principal axis. Below the principal axis. So this value will be negative again. And v naught value will be taken along the incident direction. So that this value will be positive. From this we will write what value you need. H dash by h. H dash by h is equal to v naught by u naught. H dash by h is equal to what? V naught by u naught. Therefore, we will write magnifying power is equal to general equation is equal to m is equal to, in the place of h dash by h, what we will write? V naught by u naught into d by uv. This is another equation for the magnifying power of the compound microscope. In this equation, so this v naught by u naught term is indicating what? Actually, that v naught by u naught term will be indicating the magnifying power of objective lens. So m naught is equal to what? M naught is equal to v naught by u naught. That will be indicating what? Magnifying power of the objective lens. And d by ue, this value will be indicating what? Magnifying power of the eye lens. So the general expression for the magnifying power of the compound microscope is the product of the magnifying power of the objective lens and magnifying power of the eye lens. Therefore, m is also to be written as m naught into mE. M is also to be written as m naught into mE. And one more factor also we have to measure in the case of the compound microscope. What is that? The length of the tube. The distance of separation between the objective lens and eye lens will be calling as what? Length of the tube. So here I am assuming that the length of the tube is equal to capital L. So from this diagram, this total length value is equal to V naught plus UE. Therefore, the length of the compound microscope is equal to what? L is equal to V naught plus UE. So this is the compound microscope magnifying power, and this is the what? Length of the compound microscope. So see here, case 1. So in the case 1, what we are assuming that whatever the final image you got from the compound microscope, that image will be assumed to be formed at infinite distance. So that what we are assuming that the final image I will be formed at infinity. The final image I will be formed at infinity. If the final image I will be formed at infinity means that objective distance value will be equal to what? Focal length of the eyepiece. When the final image will be formed at infinity, if the objective distance value is equal to focal length of the eyepiece, then the final image will be formed at infinite distance. Therefore, from this equation, the magnifying power of the compound microscope will be given by V naught by U naught into d by Fe. So this is a whenever the final image that is produced by the compound microscope will be formed at infinite distance, its magnifying power will be given by m is equal to what? V naught by u naught into d by Fe. Next, whenever the final image will be formed at a least distance of a distinct vision, in the case of the simple microscope, you derive the magnifying power of the eye lens. The magnifying power of the eye lens in the case of the simple microscope you derived is, that is 1 plus d by Fe. So directly we are writing that the magnifying power of the compound microscope is equal to the product of the magnifying power of the objective lens as well as magnifying power of the eye lens. Therefore, whenever the final image will be formed at least distance of a distinct vision, so m is equal to again m naught into mE. M is equal to again m naught into mE. So in this case, m naught value will be constant. That value is equal to what? V naught naught by u naught and me value is equal to what? From the simple microscope derivation, we are directly writing me value is equal to what? 1 plus d by Fe. 1 plus d by Fe. So this is the magnifying power which is produced by the given compound microscope.